And now from a continent in chaos to Britain, where, as we just heard, vaccinations are proceeding at a great pace. But one of the world's strictest lockdown remains. British Prime Minister Boris Johnson announced yesterday a cautious timetable to end it. Schools will reopen in 2 weeks, but the full lockdown won't end until June at the earliest. Special correspondent Malcolm Brabant reports on the stress that remains.
Like a murmuration of starlings, the coronavirus has been swooping unpredictably around Britain, changing shape, triggering alarm and frustration. Some of these starlings migrated from abroad, as have new variants of COVID, bringing death and prolonging the stagnation of lockdown. The casualty rate has fallen, but many restrictions will remain in place until the summer. Wilting beneath a barrage of emergency legislation and lack of social interaction, the British are near the end of their tether.
I'm a student. I had a part-time job and I lost my job because of the virus. The food I get here goes a long way.
Wanda, who came from Nigeria 10 years ago, is getting weekly supplies from a food bank specifically set up to help ethnic minorities in Brighton.
I'm just hanging by the thread. That's the right word to use, I think so.
The food bank was founded by Juliet Sekitoliko, originally from Uganda. This week she's provided more than 70 food parcels. As lockdown dragged and schools remained closed, demand increased, especially for families with children.
When the schools are open, at least that meal is covered by the school. But now, being that they're at home, more parents, they are struggling more than before.
If I don't have my children with me, I think it's going to affect me mentally. But with my children, I look at them and I say, I have to be strong for them.
Lockdown stress doesn't discriminate.
Well, I miss school because I have very good teachers and now I'm very upset that I'm at home, so I can't see them.
I missed playing with my friends.
Jago and Gus's mother is freelance writer Flora Watkins. Their sister Romy was born a few months before lockdown began. Romy has cerebral palsy.
We are very fortunate that the boys have each got a screen. We've got a nice house. There are people for whom it's immeasurably worse. But when you see children like mine who are, nice, privileged middle-class children who are in their own way showing signs of anxiety and depression. Hello, I found my six-year-old just lying on the floor of his room the other day. And I'm saying, what's wrong, darling? What's wrong? He said, Mommy, I just don't know.
Let's put this down now, please. No, I want to go through your maths with you, Gus.
Watkins put her career on hold in March last year when lockdown closed schools. Like millions of other mothers, she shoulders the burden of educating her children at home.
And how many sweets are there?
23.
If anyone had told us that actually a year later they're still going to be doing this, with no end in sight, I think there would have been an epidemic of women sticking their heads in ovens. I can't believe we've lived like this for so long.
For much of the past year, Mike Herbert has been marooned in a cramped student house in Brighton. At 27 years old, he's clinging to the hope that music can save him from 9-to-5 tedium. Herbert is currently furloughed from a part-time sales job that was funding his music degree. His lessons are remote. Collaboration, vital for musical growth, is non-existent.
It's not quite depression, but it's nearly there. It's almost despondent.
Herbert takes a rare break from solitude, visiting a friend with a home studio to record vocals for his composition, Resist. Strictly speaking, he's breaking the law.
I can resist!
My dream is to become a successful musician. That's what I've always wanted to do. And then this came and hit me like a train.
Herbert contemplated dropping out, but limited plans to reopen some university courses soon offered hope.
There's still a chance for this to work for me. I'm determined. I want to get there.
Half a mile away, Venos Savides scans the horizon for potential customers. Savides, who has Greek Cypriot heritage, manages the family fish restaurant. There's no chance of a table. Sit-down service has been banned for months.
We've definitely lost half of our revenues over the year, and we're hoping that we're going to be open in summer.
According to the planned timetable, that should happen. Until then, takeouts must suffice.
We're happy as long as we're paying all our costs and we get the exposure to our customers so you don't lose them over the long term. I think they've done a brilliant job in the UK rolling out this vaccine, and I'm hopeful that by summer we're going to see some sort of normal working conditions again.
Despite Britain's vaccination programme racing ahead, the government became increasingly authoritarian.
Virtually all foreign travel has now been outlawed, and hawkish ministers are threatening jail terms of up to 10 years and fines of nearly $14,000 for those who break lockdown laws.
One newspaper compared Britain to a prison island, on top of which Prime Minister Boris Johnson has been widely criticised for not resisting the government's cautious scientific advisers.
I sympathise very much with the exhaustion and the stress that people are experiencing and the businesses are experiencing after so long in lockdown. But to them and to them all, I say that today the end really is in sight.
The lockdown must be lifted so that we can move on, try to look for jobs to survive.
The thing that really, really makes me and a lot of my friends very, very angry is that there is absolutely no acknowledgement from this government about how hard it's been on women. It's women who are shouldering the brunt of the homeschooling, whose careers are suffering, who are being refused furlough for childcare reasons, women who are being made redundant.
And we owe mums everywhere an enormous debt of thanks for doing the enormously difficult job of juggling childcare and work at this tricky time.
There is absolutely no understanding of what it's like inhabiting the working mother sphere.
Britain's road to freedom depends on the virus. If it emulates the Starling murmuration and surges back, the country's lockdown blues will continue and possibly get worse. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Brighton.